What's up, everybody? You know the deal. It's your girl, Ombre Alert. I'm back with my second video. Thank you to everybody who watched my first video. So in today's video, we're going to be discussing the nightcap. And I know y'all heard about it because I heard about it. I saw it. I think I woke up one morning like a couple weeks ago. It happened in like July. And Forbes had released an article saying that this lady said that she invented nightcaps. And I know that in the Black community, we wear scarves, whether it's silk or satin. We wear hair wraps. We wear bandanas. This is something that we do all the time, whether it's our grandma, if you see your father or your brother with a do-rag on, a t-shirt around his head, whatever. We do this all the time. So when I heard that this white lady named Sarah has the audacity to make a nightcap, so her version of a regular bonnet for $98, like, is she tripping? Like, she's straight up tripping. Like, I don't know what was involved when she thought about doing that, because as soon as she released said bonnets or nightcaps, as she would call it, Black Twitter came for her, and I feel the same way. I feel like it's very insulting to sit here and say that you created something that already existed, like, way before you even had an experience, had a thought or anything. Just because you're dibbling and dabbling in scarves and stuff now doesn't mean that it's a fresh new idea. So I'm making this video because I think that's wrong. That's some straight up like Christopher Columbus type of crap, and you don't take credit for someone else's work. Okay, that's just not cool. Because with us in the Black community, we can go down the street and go to the beauty supply, and you have an option of different colors and different textures and things and different designs for $4. I'm not paying more than $4 for a bonnet, a nightcap, a moon cap, a Mars cap, a morning cap, a forehead cap. I'm not paying more than $4 for that, because that doesn't make any sense when it's going to be on your head. And I don't insert pictures and everything of what it looks like, and it really doesn't look cute to me, to be honest. You find a better one at the beauty supply and you'll save maybe $80-something in the process. And I don't understand, like, paying over $100 for what exactly? Something to put on your head at night, which is what, how many, depending on how many hours of sleep you get every day, that's like, what, a couple hours a day, like, that you're having it on your head. And it looks dumb. It looks like a pillowcase or something. Like, it's stupid. And you can have more variety at the beauty supply and save some money in the process. So I just wanted to, you know, make that video and just talk about that, because if that's the case, then all Black people should have money. We should get some money for advertising such a thing, because I'm sick of, like, products being reinvented by people that are confused. It's like, honey, just because you're not versed in the world, and because you've never been to the hood before, and just because you're scared of Black people when you see a Black person, it doesn't mean that you can just steal something from them and claim it as your own. That's wrong. So you can make whatever you want, make your own version of whatever, but you have to pay homage to the people that you got it from, period. Or, you know, bad things happen because you do business the wrong way. You start off offending people. That's not how you keep a business growing. That's not how you gain money, you gain success. That's just not the way you do it. And this isn't like 1962. Like, if you be racist or you say some stupid stuff, like, you have to expect backlash. And Black people, we're speaking out. We're saying what we want to now. So it's like, you have to be prepared for what people are gonna say about you if you're willing to insult people, especially with a product. And the nightcap is very insulting because, one, it's not cute. two, it's not affordable, and it shouldn't be affordable for anybody. If you can afford to I understand like $100 like bed set, like with a comforter and pillowcases and all of that, and it's like actual Egyptian cotton or silk, that's fine. But we're talking about something that you just use on your head for a couple hours a day. That doesn't really make any sense to spend $98 on that plus shipping. I didn't add the shipping. I don't know how much the shipping is gonna be, and shipping is crazy nowadays. That's another thing. So y'all just let me know how y'all feel about this, because I was offended as soon as I heard about it. I was like, this is not cool. Like, how dare she? Like, what is her problem? Is she all there? You know, is something wrong mentally? Because you don't take credit for and a product that's already invented and already sold in the hoods of America and beyond. So I just had to make a video about that. I love this hair. I'm sorry, I just get distracted a little bit sometimes. But back to my point, she's wrong. She's wrong, and she can't act like she's being attacked, because I feel attacked by your product. Your product is wrong. Your product is offensive, it's insulting. I won't be purchasing it, and I'm making this video to encourage others not to purchase it either, because it's not, no. There's nothing that it can do. Like, it has no tricks. For $98, it better be able to put, I shouldn't be able to use my hands at all to put it on. Like, it better walk towards me and climb up my motherfucking back, and it better put itself on my head. And it better also tuck me into sleep and make me go to bed, because that's the only way I see that it will be worth it. So just let me know what you guys think below. Comment, please. Subscribe. Let me know how y'all feeling, because I know how I'm feeling. I'm not with it. Get it away from me. Stop the product. Let's not do this. It's a mistake. It's just a mistake. That's just how I feel about it. Just leave your comments below, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye, y'all.